Since its introduction, iPhone has become the standard for design and ease of use, redefining what's possible on a mobile phone. And now with iPhone 3G, this revolutionary device gets even better, offering even more advanced capabilities. iPhone 3G works with fast 3G cellular and Wi-Fi networks around the world to keep you connected wherever you go. With its integrated GPS technology, iPhone 3G makes it even easier to find where you are and where you're going. iPhone 3G also supports enterprise features like Microsoft Exchange Push Email and Cisco IPsec VPN. And iPhone 3G lets you run the most amazing applications built on the world's most advanced mobile development platform. iPhone 3G combines three products into one small, lightweight device. It's a great mobile phone, a widescreen iPod, and a breakthrough internet communications device with the best email, web browsing, search, and maps applications ever on a mobile phone. At the heart of iPhone 3G is an operating system that's years ahead of other mobile devices. It includes a multi-touch user interface that lets you easily control everything with just the touch of a finger. Over the next 30 minutes or so, I'd like to give you a brief tour of some of the amazing features that make iPhone 3G so revolutionary. One of the first things you'll notice about iPhone 3G is its simple, sculpted design that feels great in your hand. On the left side of iPhone, you'll find a volume up and down button and a silent ringer switch. On the top is the sleep-wake button and the headset jack. On the bottom is the iPod connector, a speaker, and the mic. To unlock iPhone, press the sleep-wake button, then drag the slider to the right. The slider prevents iPhone from being accidentally turned on while in your pocket. This is iPhone's home screen. From here, you can begin using the amazing built-in applications just by tapping on a button such as SMS, Maps, or Weather. Along the bottom of the home screen are the buttons to quickly access the phone, mail, Safari, and iPod features of iPhone. And this is the home button. Pressing the home button at any time from anywhere brings you back to the home screen. You can lock your iPhone by pressing the sleep-wake button. iPhone will still receive calls, and you can listen to music, adjust the volume, and use the stereo headset, but nothing will happen if you touch the screen. To completely power off iPhone, press and hold the sleep-wake button for a few seconds. Then drag the red slider to confirm. iPhone is a revolutionary mobile phone. Making a call is as simple as touching a name. And because iPhone automatically syncs with the address book you already use on your PC or Mac, you have all of your contacts, phone numbers, street addresses, email addresses, and more with you wherever you go. More importantly, you can use this information inside of other iPhone applications like Google Maps, Safari, and Mail. To make a phone call, start by tapping on the phone button. There are five buttons along the bottom of the screen so that you can quickly access favorites, recents, your contacts, a numeric keypad, and visual voicemail. You can easily scroll through all of your contacts by flicking up or down, or you can drag your finger along the alphabet on the right to quickly jump to a particular letter. Tapping the status bar will always scroll you back to the top of the list. If you have a lot of contacts in your address book, you can also type the person's name in the search field, and a list of matching names will appear. And if you're using iPhone with Microsoft Exchange, you can even look up contacts within your company's global address list. To call Emily, I'd tap her name, then simply tap on a number to make the call. It's as easy as that. Anytime you're on a call, you can tap mute to mute your line, tap speaker to use the speakerphone, tap the hold button to put the call on hold, or tap keypad to bring up the numeric keypad. You can also create a simple conference call by tapping Add Call, or access information in your address book by tapping Contacts. While on a call, you can also press the Home button at any time to access other iPhone applications. With a 3G or Wi-Fi connection, you can continue your conversation while simultaneously syncing email, surfing the web, or using most any other feature. To return to the call, tap here. When you're done with the call, simply tap End Call. Favorites is a great way to speed dial someone with one tap. To add John Appleseed to my favorites list, I tap the plus button, then his name. You can also edit your favorites list by tapping here. For example, to reorder my list, I touch to the right of a name and drag it to the position I want. And if I want to delete a name from the list, I tap the red circle next to the name, then tap Remove. Recents gives you a list of all the dialed, received, and missed calls. Missed calls are displayed in red, and tapping on the Missed button shows a list of just the missed calls. To return a call, just tap on the name. Tap on the blue arrow to see all of the contact information for that person. Wouldn't it be nice to listen to your voicemails in any order? Wouldn't it also be nice to see the names of the people who've left you a message? Well, with iPhone and Visual Voicemail, you can. To access Visual Voicemail, tap the Voicemail button. The blue dot lets you know which ones haven't been listened to. You can listen to any voicemail in any order just by tapping on it.
Hi, Bob. It's Anna here from marketing. Can you give me a call when you get out of your meeting? I have a couple new ideas about our brochure.
To repeat a section, you can easily scroll back and play it again. To return a call from a voicemail, tap the callback button. iPhone's a great widescreen iPod. It has a beautiful 3.5-inch screen that's perfect for displaying your pictures, video podcasts, TV shows, and movies. To use the iPod features, just tap on the iPod button. Just like in the phone application, there are five buttons along the bottom. These let you navigate your music library by playlists, artists, songs, as well as easily get to your videos, and more. To see your music sorted by artist, tap on the Artist button. Then scroll to find a favorite artist, choose an album, then a song. To see the album's complete track list, tap here. Then tap on any song to switch the track that's playing. Another great way to look at your music library is with CoverFlow, just like in iTunes. CoverFlow lets you enjoy your entire music library using album cover art. To use CoverFlow, all you have to do is rotate your iPhone 90 degrees. iPhone's accelerometer senses the change and automatically switches into CoverFlow. Just flick your finger left and right to find the album you want, tap on it, then tap on the song you want to listen to. And that's CoverFlow. Now let's take a look at video. To access movies, TV shows, music videos, and video podcasts, tap the Videos button. Here you can see a list of all the video content available on your iPhone. To watch a movie, just tap on it. Movies and video play in landscape, so you want to rotate your iPhone. You can double tap to see the movie in full widescreen theatrical aspect ratio. If you want to zoom back into full screen, double tap again. Tap once on the display to bring up the on-screen controls. Tap again to put them away. In addition to purchase movies, you can also rent movies from iTunes and watch them on your iPhone. Rented movies appear here at the top. Each rented movie will have an expiration date, and the time remaining on your rental will show up here. After the movie's rental period ends, it'll be automatically deleted. Wouldn't it be great if you could discover, preview, and get new music on the go? With the iTunes Wi-Fi Music Store, you can. Songs and albums download directly to your iPhone, so you can enjoy them immediately. To access the iTunes Wi-Fi Music Store, your iPhone just needs to be connected to a Wi-Fi network. You could be at home, work, school, Starbucks, or almost any Wi-Fi hotspot. Any music purchased from the iTunes Wi-Fi Music Store will be uploaded to your computer when you sync. To browse and shop on the iTunes Wi-Fi Music Store, just tap the iTunes button. Here you can check out the featured songs, a a list of the top 10 songs and albums, search for a particular song or artist, or check the status of your downloads. You can find exactly what you're looking for with a quick search of the iTunes Wi-Fi Music Store. Tap the search button, then type an artist's name. Notice the autocomplete feature as you type. Select the artist you're looking for from the search results. To listen to a 30-second preview of a song, just tap it. To stop the playback, just tap here. When you find something you like, tap here, then tap Buy Now to download. Remember, any music purchased from the iTunes Wi-Fi Music Store will be uploaded to your computer next time you sync. The stereo headset that comes with iPhone features a microphone with an integrated button that allows you to answer and end calls easily. It can also be used to control audio and video playback. While using the iPod features, for example, a single click pauses or resumes playback, and a double click advances one track in a playlist. If a call comes in while you're listening to music, a single click on the headphone button will answer the call and fade the music. When you're done with the call, click once more to hang up. The music will fade back in right where you left off. There are two great ways to enjoy photos on iPhone. The first is to capture snapshots with the built-in camera, and the second is to sync your favorite photos from your computer so you have them with you wherever you go. To see photos on iPhone, start by tapping Photos. Here you see all of your photo albums, as well as the pictures you've taken with the camera. Let's take a look at a set of pictures from a recent vacation. Tap on any thumbnail to see the picture full screen, then flick left or right to scroll to the next image. When you come to a picture that's in landscape, simply rotate iPhone and the image fills up the display. To see all the detail in this image, you can zoom in by pinching out and move the image around by dragging. Zooming back out is just a double tap away. You can see all of the pictures you've taken with your iPhone by looking in the camera roll. Here is a great picture of my friend Chris. To make it his picture in my address book, so it appears every time he calls, I simply tap this icon. From here, I can choose to use it as my wallpaper, email it, or assign it to a contact. I'll select Chris's name from my address book, tap Set Photo, and I'm done. iPhone delivers the real internet, with the best email, web browsing, search, and maps applications ever on a mobile phone. Using the Safari web browser, iPhone renders web pages just as they'd look on your computer. And using built-in Wi-Fi and 3G cellular technologies, iPhone will download and display these pages fast. From the home screen, tap here to launch the Safari web browser. You can use bookmarks to easily navigate to your favorite websites. And you can sync your bookmarks from your PC or Mac. To surf to a website using your bookmarks, tap here, then tap on the name of the website. I can scroll through the entire web page from top to bottom just by flicking and dragging. To zoom in, simply double tap. Safari enlarges the section you've chosen and fits it to the screen. To pan around, just drag. And to zoom back out, just double tap again. Searching the web on iPhone is easy. To begin a web search, tap here. Type in a word or phrase. Let's look for a travel guide. Then tap Google. Google is preset as the default search on iPhone, but you can easily set Yahoo search as well. You can view a web page in either portrait or landscape mode. Simply rotate iPhone 90 degrees, and the web page rotates too. To open an additional web page, tap here. Then tap New Page. Tap in the address field to bring up the keyboard and enter a web address. Notice the .com button on the keyboard. Then tap Go. Email on iPhone looks great. It supports the most popular email systems, including Yahoo Mail, Google's Gmail, AOL, or most any industry-standard IMAP or POP mail system. And now we've added Push Email for Microsoft Exchange and Apple's MobileMe service. iPhone supports rich HTML email, so images and photos display in line with the text. iPhone also lets you view many attachments such as PDF, JPEG, Microsoft Word, Excel, and PowerPoint files, and works great with Apple's iWork. All this and more makes email on iPhone the best ever on a mobile device. To launch email, tap the Mail button. This is my inbox. The blue dots let me know which emails have not been read. I can quickly scan my inbox for unread messages and return to the top by tapping the status bar. Tap on an email to read it. This email has two image attachments that I can see right in line with the email message. Tapping and holding an image lets me save it to my photo library. Tap Inbox to go back to your inbox. Keeping your inbox organized is easy. You can delete a message by swiping to the right across an email, then tap the Delete button. To delete multiple email messages, just tap Edit, then tap the circle to the left of each message you want to delete, then tap Delete. Moving messages into another mail folder is just as easy. Tap Edit, then tap the circle to the left of each message, tap Move, and then tap the folder you want them to go into. Let's look at another email message. This email has a PDF and a Microsoft PowerPoint presentation attached. To view the attachments, I simply tap on them. I can pinch to zoom in and drag to pan around. I'll tap Message to go back, then tap on the Microsoft PowerPoint file. If I want to view the attachment in landscape, I simply rotate iPhone. I can reply to or forward this message by tapping here. Or I can write a new email message by tapping the Compose button. In the To field, you can tap the plus button to select someone from your address book, or you can just start typing the person's name or email address. You can speed things up by picking their name from the list of matches in your address book. Many iPhone applications are integrated with one another. For example, tapping on a web address in an email launches that website in Safari, and tapping on a phone number calls that number. iPhone is the most advanced keyboard of any mobile phone today, and all of this advanced technology makes typing both accurate and easy. iPhone constantly analyzes your keystrokes to suggest words as you type, and it uses an entire dictionary and learns the words you type most often, including proper names and everything in your address book. While the tiny physical keys stay fixed in one place on other mobile handsets, iPhone adapts its keys and layouts for different applications. With iPhone, you get exactly the right keyboard for the task at hand. Another thing you'll notice is that it only appears when you need it, giving you even more room for viewing web pages, emails, maps, or even watching a movie. This is iPhone's standard keyboard, one key for each letter of the alphabet. You can access numbers and common punctuation and symbols by tapping here. When you begin typing on iPhone, it's best to start with just one index finger. At first, be very deliberate with your finger taps. Pay particular attention to the confirmation pop-ups and where your finger touches the screen. If you make a mistake while typing, this is the backspace button. If you want to reposition your cursor to insert a word, you can use the magnifying glass by touching and dragging it to the right position. If you double tap the space bar at the end of a sentence, the keyboard intelligently inserts a period and a space, then automatically sets the uppercase button so you're ready to begin the next sentence. As you type, iPhone tracks and compares what you're typing to its built-in dictionary. It constantly looks for words similar to what you're typing. When it finds a match or a mistake, iPhone makes a suggestion. To decline, just tap the suggested word. You can accept it by tapping the space bar. To further improve your typing accuracy, iPhone also employs complex mathematics to help correct mistakes by tracking the pattern of letters you type and matching them to the pattern of other common words. Let's say I was typing the word pizza. Instead of typing P-I-Z-Z-A, I'll type O-U-Z-Z-A. iPhone analyzes what I've typed and correctly predicts that I meant to type P instead of O and I instead of U, and offers pizza as a suggestion. I'll accept the suggestion by tapping the space bar. To make typing even faster, iPhone also suggests common English contractions such as can't, don't, or let's. To lock caps, I just double tap the uppercase button. And to quickly insert a character from another language, I just hold down a related letter, then slide my finger to it. As you become more proficient, you can migrate to using two thumbs. The trick is just type away and trust the intelligence of the keyboard. And in less than a week, you'll likely be typing faster on iPhone than on any other small keyboard. Unlike the fixed physical keyboards on other phones, iPhone's intelligent keyboard design also allows users to switch between any of 21 international layouts with a single touch. After turning on the keyboards you want to use from within Settings, you can tap here to quickly switch between keyboard layouts. iPhone even includes a new fast input Japanese Kana keyboard and handwriting character recognition for simplified and traditional Chinese. Staying on top of your schedule is a snap with the calendar on iPhone. You can sync your appointments and events with a Mac or PC via iTunes. Or, if you use the Mobile Me service or Microsoft Exchange, you can wirelessly keep your calendar up to date even when you're out and about. Tap Calendar, and then choose from one of three views: Month, List, or Day. Within the Day view, I can scroll through the events in my calendar to see what's coming up, and then tap on an event to see the details. To add a new calendar event, I just tap here. You've probably noticed that my appointments are different colors. That's because I've organized them on my desktop computer into different calendars, and iPhone keeps them that way. If you wirelessly sync your calendar with Microsoft Exchange, you can receive and accept meeting invitations from your colleagues. A list of all pending invitations can be viewed here, and individual invitations also appear on your calendar like this. Just tap the invitation to see the meeting details. To respond, tap Accept, Maybe, or Decline, and a notification will be sent to the meeting organizer. iPhone displays SMS text messages as an ongoing conversation. Because iPhone maintains a complete history of your dialogue, it's easy to pick up an SMS session exactly where you left off. Tap SMS. Here I see a list of all the SMS sessions currently on my iPhone. A blue dot marks any unread messages. I can view the complete conversation by scrolling through the message history. To reply, tap here and type a response using the keyboard. Then tap Send. You can also tap on a phone number in a text message to instantly call that person. To compose a new SMS text message, tap the Compose button. In the To field, you can type a phone number or tap the plus button to select someone from your address book. You can even send the message to more than one person. Compose your message. Then tap Send. Because iPhone saves a history of your text messages, with one tap, you can send a new message to the same person or group. One of the most useful tools available on the internet today is Maps. And Google Maps on iPhone is amazing. How many times have you been walking or driving around a city in search of a cup of coffee or a particular address? Have you ever wished your phone could help you find exactly what you're looking for? Maps on iPhone delivers. To get started, tap on Maps. To find a map of a particular city or location, just tap in the search field and enter the address, the city name, or even just the zip code. If you want to find your location at any given moment, iPhone 3G knows where you are, even if you don't. Tap the tracking button, and iPhone's built-in GPS technology will zero in on your current location and track you as you move from place to place. And if a GPS signal isn't available, iPhone can determine your position using Wi-Fi and cellular tower information. With any map, you can zoom in on a section by pinching or double tapping. To zoom out, tap once with two fingers. And to pan around, simply move your finger across the map. Now that iPhone knows my current location, I can easily search for nearby businesses or points of interest. Let me show you how easy it is to find a restaurant and get directions with iPhone. I can even check the traffic. I'm going to look for pizza. I tap in the search field, type pizza, then search. Looks like I have quite a few options, and you can see each by tapping on the pin. Tap the blue arrow to see all the details for the restaurant, including address, website, and phone number. I can even bookmark it. Getting directions to the restaurant is simple. Tap here and notice my current location is already set. Tap route and get ready for the trip. The only unknown is traffic, but Maps even has that taken care of. Curl up the map page to reveal other options, including the ability to change the map view, drop a pin, and show the current local traffic conditions. Green lines indicate everything is flowing smoothly, while yellow and red lines mean problems ahead. From here to the restaurant, all you or your co-pilot have to do is step through the directions and enjoy the trip. iPhone comes with several useful applications such as Notes, Clock, Calculator, Stocks, and Weather. Stocks and Weather are two that utilize the wireless network to bring you the latest information. To check the weather forecast in a city, start by tapping on the Weather button. You can flick through different cities by dragging your finger left or right. To add a new city, tap the Information button. Then tap Plus and type the name of the city. Then tap Search. And done. You can even tell the difference between day and night. The Stocks application shows a list of company stock quotes and a graph of their share price over time. Tapping here toggles this information between the percent gain or loss and the absolute gain or loss. iPhone is a revolutionary phone, a widescreen iPod, and puts the internet in your pocket. And now, developers from all over the world can create new and innovative applications for iPhone that leverage iPhone's groundbreaking technologies like the multi-touch user interface, animation technology, the built-in accelerometer, and location services. All of this makes iPhone the world's best mobile platform, with new applications that are unlike anything you've seen before on a mobile phone. Games pop off of iPhone's widescreen display with incredible 3D graphics and 3D positional sound. And with iPhone's built-in accelerometer, you'll be able to tap and tilt to control the action for the best game playing experience ever on a mobile phone. With iPhone, you won't have to be tied to your desktop to update your blog, follow your team, manage your business, or study for that test. Using the built-in multi-touch technology, fast wireless connectivity, and integration with Contacts, Photos, Safari, and more, applications on iPhone will help you accomplish the task at hand quickly and easily. No matter what you're interested in, gaming, chatting, social networking, traveling, news, sports, finance, or business, there'll be iPhone applications made especially for you. Discovering and downloading these amazing iPhone applications is just a few taps away with the built-in App Store. The App Store is a breakthrough way for developers to wirelessly deliver their applications to every iPhone user. To browse and shop for iPhone applications, just tap the App Store button. You can view the list of featured applications, search by category, look at a list of the most popular applications, search by name, or see which of your applications have new versions available. Tapping an item will display the application's details where you can read the description, view a screenshot, or see reviews from other people. To buy the application or to download one of the many free applications, just tap here. Then tap Buy Now to download. If prompted, type in your iTunes account password. Once you've purchased an application, it'll appear on the home screen. The progress bar indicates that it's currently downloading. It can be downloaded over the wireless cellular network, but if the size of the app is large, you may be instructed to use Wi-Fi. After the download is complete, just tap on the application to launch it. Not only can you download applications right to your iPhone, the App Store will let you know when new versions of your applications are available. You can also purchase applications from iTunes on your Mac or PC and sync them to your iPhone. There are many ways to configure and customize your iPhone. You can sync your own content, rearrange the home screen, and change many of the default settings so that iPhone works best for you. Syncing and managing your content on iPhone couldn't be easier. You do it all through iTunes using your Mac or PC. In fact, if you have an iPod, you already know how to sync an iPhone. It works exactly the same way. With iTunes, it's simple to set up your iPhone right from the start with your contacts, calendar, email, bookmarks, ringtones, favorite music, TV shows, movies, and more. When you connect iPhone to your PC or Mac, it automatically shows up in iTunes ready to sync. iTunes will then show you several tabs where you can manage the content on your iPhone. The Summary tab displays basic information about your iPhone. Check here for any software updates or to perform a software restore if necessary. The Info tab is where you select which address books, calendars, and web bookmarks you'd like to sync with iPhone. If you've made your own unique ringtones in iTunes, you can sync them to iPhone from here. The Music tab displays a list of all of your iTunes playlists. You can sync your entire music library or sync specific playlists. iPhone is a great way to show off your pictures. To select which photos to sync, use the Photos tab. In the Podcasts tab, you can choose the audio and video podcast you'd like to sync. The Video tab lets you sync your TV shows and movies. Remember, video files, especially feature films, can take up significant space and a bit of time to sync. So to get started quickly, just choose the most recent or unwatched TV show you like, or your favorite movie. If you download an application from the App Store to your desktop, you can sync the application to your iPhone from here in the Apps tab. When you're done making your selections, just click on Apply and iTunes will do the rest. iTunes displays the status of your sync and alerts you when it's okay to disconnect. This bar at the bottom shows you how much room you have left on your iPhone and updates every time you sync. If you run out of room, iTunes will prompt you to remove some content. If you happen to receive a call while syncing, iTunes will cancel the sync to allow you to answer the phone. If you have websites that you frequently check, a favorite newspaper, blog, or sports site, why not create an icon on the home screen that will take you directly there? Let's say you like to check the New York Times every morning. Notice the plus button. Tapping the plus brings up a menu where you can add a bookmark, add to home screen, or email someone a link to this website. If you tap Add to Home Screen, you can rename the icon, then tap Add to place the new web clip on your home screen. Another great way to personalize your iPhone is to customize the icons on your home screens. You can arrange the icons however you like, change the icons on your dock, and even have multiple home screen pages. In fact, you can have up to 9 home screen pages with space for web clips, web apps, and applications from the App Store. To customize the arrangement of icons on your home screen, tap and hold any icon for a second or two until you see all the icons start to wiggle. You can then drag any icon to a new location. To move an icon to a different home screen, drag the icon to the edge of the screen and slide to the next page. If you'd like a different icon in the dock, first move one away, then drag a new one in. The dock icons are displayed on every home screen. If you want to delete a web clip, just tap the X in the upper left of the icon, then tap Delete to confirm. When you're finished customizing your home screens, press the Home button to lock everything in place. If you have multiple pages, the total number of pages and the position of the currently displayed page will be shown here. To move between home screens, just flick left or right. iPhone comes preloaded with some great ringtones, and you can even add your own. Tap Settings, Sounds, and then tap here to see all the ringtones on your iPhone. To listen to a ringtone, just tap it. A check mark indicates which ringtone will be used when your phone rings. Custom ringtones you've made in iTunes will appear at the top of the list. To personalize your iPhone even more, you can also assign ringtones to different people in your address book. With custom ringtones, everyone you know can have their own unique identifying sound. You can select an image on your iPhone to use as your wallpaper. To change your wallpaper, tap Wallpaper. You can select a new wallpaper image from the default gallery or any other image on your iPhone. Find a new image, then press Set Wallpaper. Want to keep using your iPhone after your plane takes off? Just turn on airplane mode. With airplane mode activated, your iPhone won't emit cellular, Wi-Fi, or Bluetooth signals. That means you can keep listening to music, watching a movie, or playing a game while en route. And if your flight offers a Wi-Fi data connection, you can turn Wi-Fi back on without turning on your cellular radio. So that's a brief look at iPhone 3G. I've shown you what a revolutionary phone it is, how it's a great widescreen iPod, and how it delivers the incredible power of having the real internet wherever you are. All of this combined into one small, amazing device that now keeps you connected around the world on fast 3G cellular networks. If you don't already have an iPhone, nothing compares to holding one in your own hand and experiencing each amazing iPhone feature. Go to your local Apple or AT&T store to experience one for yourself. Thank you.